wake, hear the birds and see the sun. Side by side, our fears are done. Oh, the good times just begun. We know what we have, let's hold on tight.
There's a few things in life that I actually prefer the cheaper version of. I prefer cola, cheap cola, to proper Coca-Cola. I prefer own brand baked beans to Heinz baked beans. I prefer buying just bog standard 14p paracetamol rather than expensive Nurofen. But in the world of like climbing and mountaineering, I've been trying to think of things where I prefer the cheap version. I'm really struggling, if I'm honest. We've all bought the cheaper stuff, those budget brands. You know, can't always afford the Gucci, Patagonia stuff and whatever else. So I've certainly had my fair share of cheaper kit, but often you know you really want the more expensive thing. Some things in life, it's not very exciting. Some bits of outdoor kit you get excited about buying, don't you? I don't know, shiny set of cams or something, a new tent, something like that. I do anyway. Over trousers though, waterproof trousers, they're one of those things that I can't really get excited by trousers. And I've always been, I've had so many pairs of waterproof trousers, I'm getting a bit wound up already just thinking about how many pairs of over trousers I've had. I've never really had a pair that I've been 100% happy with. I've had all sorts of brands. I've had some Rab ones, Crux ones, Mountain Equipment ones, Hagloffs, Arc'teryx. The Arc'teryx ones are the best I've had. They're still going all right, actually. They're not perfect. They're actually kind of more of a skiing pair. They're the best I could find at the time, but lots of good points. But today's video is about the Simmond mountaineering waterproof trousers that I've been using. So you'll join me in a minute when I've walked up further onto the hill, and we'll have a little chat about, now having used them for a little bit, whether they are the bargain I hoped they would be, or whether they're not. Now it's probably a bit unfair to compare these $89.99 Simmond pants to like the Arc'teryx ones that I mentioned on the walk up that were a lot more money. Simmond are owned by Decathlon, they have been since 2008 I think, so it's easy to judge them as a bit, you know, an own brand kind of brand. But Simmond have got a lot of history, certainly back in the day in like the 80s and stuff, their ice axes were sort of legendary, anyone who was anyone had a pair of them. But they still make some really good kit now. Some of their rucksacks are an absolute bargain, especially their little lightweight things. I had this down jacket by Simmond once. It was about 25 euros. I bought it in Chamonix. It was brilliant, lightweight, because it's 25 euros, wasn't too bothered if it got a rip or anything in it. I still use some of their gloves that are great, and they're about 25 quid, waterproof, warm enough, and they outperform some more expensive brands. So when I was browsing for new over trousers, they did catch my eye. I thought they were worth a look. They look really good. You know, the bright blue colour makes a change from boring black waterproof trousers, doesn't it? My Arc'teryx ones are as bright yellow, but not many are good colours really. So that did grab my eye, and then the price grabbed my eye. They are fully waterproof. They've got a hydrostatic head of 20,000 millimetres. They should be fine, and in my use they have been fine in essence. The material is no problem in terms of keeping the water out. Would I buy them again though, and would I recommend them? Well, let's have a quick look at the features. I've put the GoPro on as well so I can kind of talk about a few bits and pieces. I sort of start from the bottom really. They kind of got a elasticated cuff around the ankle, and then they've got this zip that kind of comes halfway up the calf. The trouble with the zip is it doesn't actually open things up very much. They are really narrow fit, and I'll come back onto that in a minute. Just up here, if I roll my trousers off, I'm in jeans because I'm only above the hill, I'm not actually in the mountains. They've got a zip there, and they have a detachable pair of snow gaiters that I've taken off because I don't really like those even when I am out in the snow.
If I go a bit further though, you'll see they have this mesh lining, pretty standard in sort of a lot of cheaper waterproofs. I'll come on to that in a minute though. The problem with the slim fit and this zip not being, you know, fully opening up is, being a big footed person, size 12s for me, I just can't really get them on very easily over boots. So I can just about do it, but as soon as it's sort of raining a bit and I'm in a rush and I've got cold fingers and stuff like that, it's really problematic. The boy's feeling sympathetic for me, obviously, warming my fingers up. He's like a little hot water bottle. Go on, off you go, complete your stick. Amuse yourself. So really, I think even if you've got smaller feet, you're going to struggle because, like I said, they are slim, but your boots get caught on that mesh all the time as well. So you're forever, like, as you're putting your legs through, you're sort of peeling the mesh off the back of your boots. So they're kind of almost too awkward. Better off without the zip at all, to be honest, to save weight. My Arc'teryx ones haven't got a zip at all, so I had to fully accept I do have to take boots off to do that. But when you do take a boot off, it takes about 2 seconds to pull them over. The mesh is really annoying. The mesh does help with the breathability. It helps wick the sweat away. And I have found these to be really nice and breathable, actually. So that's definitely a good point. Down at this end again, they've got a bit of reinforcement there for where your crampons might catch. And that's where the slim fit is good for me. So many over trousers are flipping so baggy that they look a bit silly. And all this stuff, that it does kind of catch on crampons and other bits, whereas the slimmer fit I do like. I only have skinny legs, so if you do have chunky legs, you might struggle with these. Size wise, I'm pretty long legged and a 33 waist, and I got a large, and they come up much more like a medium. So if you are buying them without trying on, definitely go a size up if you're tempted by them. Moving up through the trouser, no reinforcement on the knee, unlike this bit, which is a bit of a shame because, you know, mountaineering and stuff, you're always, you know, you're on your knees on a route occasionally, or just bending down to get something out of your rucksack. I'd like to see some reinforcement there. As you come up, put the GoPro back on, it's got reinforcement here, and it does look very much like it's a, sort of a glued on pocket, which some over trousers have. I did actually put my keys in this pocket one day out on an ML up on a garn somewhere. And then I realised later on that it wasn't a pocket, it's just a vent. And I like vents, but it caught me out, that one. Thankfully, this aforementioned mesh that I've been moaning about, the keys got stuck on that, so they didn't disappear out the bottom somewhere on the side of a mountain. So just be aware of that. That's my fault, though. Didn't check them out properly first. They have got pockets up here. Nice ones, good size. But the problem is, it goes through to this mesh that you can just about see, and then through to the trousers. So the pockets aren't waterproof. That might not bother you, it does bother me. I want my waterproofs to be actual as waterproof as possible. So pockets, I want them to be waterproof because they do fill up with water. He's feeling needy today. Yeah, the pockets do fill up with water. And if they are waterproof, it's not the end of the world because, go away boy, go off you. They, you know, at least it keeps the water out for a while. All waterproofs will fail eventually. There's only so much they can do. I don't like the mesh ones. Going further up here, they've got some adjustment just for fine tuning, some Velcro, that works quite well. A couple of buttons there, flies as always. And then they have got braces as well. They're fairly, you know, they're comfortable, they do the job. They work just fine. I like braces on over trousers, but they are removable if you want to take them off. So, what are they suited for? I guess that's the question when we're judging these. On the blurb on the Decathlon site, it does talk about them having input from their Alpine guides into the design of these, and it shows. I think that's what they're better for. For an Alpine type day, when any precipitation is more likely to be snow rather than rain, I think they're probably pretty good at keeping you dry in that kind of environment, or the odd shower, that sort of stuff. Waterproof zips, they're just not actually that waterproof. I'd much rather have a flap, you know, even this expensive Patagonia one doesn't, but the pockets, they are sealed at least. They're sort of fashionable because they look good and they're nice and light and all that kind of thing, but the reality is they just don't work very well. Storm flaps are the way forwards. This little pocket has one. I'd rather just have big storm flaps over everything. So whilst the waterproof fabric itself is really good in my experience so far, I just don't think the design is particularly watertight. The other thing of using them as over trousers to carry in your bag and put over your boots and stuff, that is a bit problematic, like I say, just because they are awkward to get on. So they kind of feel like those pair of trousers that you're going to put on at the start of the day when you get out of the car and then leave on for the rest of the day, because they are breathable. They have got those vents, so you can do that. So if I was in, you know, Chamonix doing the Cosmique Arête or something, I might, in the right weather, put these on at the start of the day over a thin pair of trousers. I suspect some people put them on over a thin pair of merino type things. It'd work quite well for that if you're going to keep them on all day. For me, I'd use a thin pair of trousers. They're nice and light though, so you know they are okay to carry in your pack. I'm just not sure they're the ideal thing to then get out of the pack. You think of like Wales, lakes, Scottish winters, that kind of stuff. It's just too wet, I reckon, so I don't think they're ideal for that. Would I recommend them? There's loads of pluses to them, and the price is a bargain. I'd rather personally spend a bit more on a better pair though, that's a bit more flexible. So I was really interested to try these, and I was really hopeful that they would be really good and outperform some other stuff. I'm just not sure they're quite right for me. Doesn't mean they're not right for everyone, but I just don't think they're the right kind of pair for me. I will keep wearing them because I've bought them now, so I'm going to keep wearing them. I do like the look. I like the fit because it suits me. They are, you know, still easy to get your leg up even though they're slim fit, you know, onto those higher holds. It seems to have a nice cut to the trouser. But I think they're just sadly flawed in other ways. I hope that was useful, because I did have a lot of requests for this video after I put some stuff on Instagram, having bought them. Can you hear the planes? That's the RAF trainer ones there. Sounds like World War II going on. Snowdon covered in cloud in the background. It's a stunning day, actually. Pretty chilly on the hands, though. Certainly winter is on its way. Do fire away with questions. If I've missed anything that you need to know, put it in the comments below and I'll answer as best I can. Apparently Patagonia have some nice ones coming out this season, so keep your eyes peeled for them. I certainly will be. They could be the ones for me, but I think they're in black again, so it's a bit disappointing. Can't have it all. Like I say, do fire away with those questions. The boy's looking majestic over there, catching the sun. Find us on Insta, find us on Facebook, click the like button, smash the subscribe button. The support, as always, massively appreciated. It still blows my mind, so massive, massive thanks for that. As always though, thanks very much for watching. More videos coming up very soon. Side by side, our fears are done. All the good times just begun. We know what we have, let's hold on tight.